Hey guys, how's it going?
I'm back with another video. I know it's been a while since I last posted. I meant to post earlier, but I managed to actually play Madden 20 over the weekend, so I couldn't stream that. So I actually have to give you guys a video without gameplay. So EA, if you're watching this, there will not be any gameplay in this video, trust me. The thing's already expired. I didn't take any video clips, and I did not take any screenshots from it, except for like maybe two I saved for myself just to remember the game. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the good, the bad, and what my personal opinion was on the game. So first things first, we're going to get to the good. The shoelace tackles have been completely nerfed. Like, I didn't even see one. I played about 5 to 8 hours the entire weekend, which is pretty dang good. I'm glad to see those are gone because there would be like some elite, like maybe 87 overall, who would have like 85 pursuit, and he'd catch you. And you were on like an 80-yard run, well, it's gone because shoelace tackle. That doesn't happen. Thank God. The running mechanics are a lot more smoother. Skill moves are all needed. I didn't really. The spin move didn't actually work that much. And I used a lot of the spin move because I wanted to see if it was gonna still work like it did in the last year's game. It didn't.
Worked out much, yeah.
They had to use some trucking, some juking. So yeah, that's pretty good if you ask me. Another thing I noticed was that quarterbacks, if you threw on the run or something like that, there would be like a small tendency to actually make that throw work. Like if you're throwing on the run an open crosser route, you'd probably make that throw depending on who you have at quarterback. But if you're throwing across your body, that throw from time to time will not get there. I was playing a fantasy draft with Russell Wilson on a franchise. And from time to time, he would not make that throw on if he was cross-bodying it. Why'd that water bottle was this? Anyway, another thing I noticed in the game
Was how well the receiver.
receivers played as well. They weren't dropping too many footballs. I mean, and also the defense was really good to use as well. You could actually user pick really nicely. I got a lot of user alerts during my time playing. It was really nice, honestly. It felt like Madden 11. But with just improved graphics and a better like user mechanic system on defense. Like I can user my safety and get some easy user alerts if I
Did
play
my
Madden
defense
11.
right, and by the way,
I wasn't all pro mode the entire time. So I didn't play anything on pro, I didn't play rookie, I was on sim. So yeah. Alright, to the bad. X-Factor players are really overpowered, which is a big problem. Like linebackers, if you get anywhere near their zone, they'll hit stick you every time. But if you manage to get out of their zone somehow, there's always that risk of the safety hitting you, especially, what's his name? Keanu Neal? I don't know, Keanu Neal, whatever it is. The safety on the Falcons. His hit power is a 97 to start out the game, which I don't know why it was that high, but every time I got near him, it was an immediate hit stick and I was fumbling. I really think should be toned down a little bit at least. I know they're supposed to be
overpower
overpowered
their X factor.
X-Factor players, but tone them down at least. The defensive linemen, X-Factor players, were getting through
Super
quite
easily with
easily.
block shed.
Linebackers were popping me pretty much every time I got anywhere near them. And receivers would
Catch
catch
almost anything.
anything if once they got it. And
And
they
quarterbacks didn't really
didn't
affect
affect the game too much, actually. Which kind of surprised me as a field general. Quarterbacks should have more of a chance to take over, but for some reason it just didn't happen. Anyway, now let's get to my personal opinion on the game. I think the game runs a lot more smoother. It's actually going to be really good compared to Madden 19. I enjoyed playing the game a lot. Online actually felt really good. So honestly, I'd give this game a try. If they could stick with the stuff they had in the beta, this will be a great game, trust me. So yeah, it's gonna be fun to play. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys actually do consider buying Madden 20. I mean, I know you guys aren't really fans of EA after Madden 19, but I recommend you guys give it a shot. Anyways, that's it for me. I'll see you guys in the next video.